Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to the class. Today's topic is line spectrum of hydrogen atom. In the periodic table, we know 118 elements are present in the periodic table. Among the 118 elements, the first most element is the hydrogen. And we know the atomic number of hydrogen as 1. In the last class, I discussed that hydrogen is going to exist in 3 isotopic forms, protium, deuterium, and tritium, H11, H12, and H13. We are discussing only about H11. H11 contains 1 electron and 1 proton, but not neutron. So it is the arrangement of proton and electron only. And this was explained by the scientist Niels Bohr, by considering 2 theories, Rutherford's model of atom as well as Planck's quantum theory. So before going to the Niels Bohr's model of atom, we have to understand quantization of energies of electrons in the atom. So to understand that one, we should understand the spectrum. So today we are going to discuss the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. Yes, first of all, we are not having the hydrogen atoms in the free state. In the free state, atoms are not going to get exist. The atoms are going to get exist in the molecular form. So hydrogen atoms, when the one hydrogen atom is going to be bonded with another hydrogen atom to form a molecule H2, two atoms are there in this molecule. This molecule is called as a diatomic molecule. Once again, when a molecule is going to contain only 2 atoms, such molecules are called as diatomic molecule. So to explain the line spectrum, we are going to take hydrogen gas. Where this hydrogen gas is taken? The hydrogen gas is taken in an electric discharge tube, and that is vacuum. Vacuum means having very, very low pressure. So at the low pressure in the electric discharge tube, we are taking some amount of hydrogen gas. That hydrogen gas is going to contain so many molecules of hydrogen. Suppose if I am saying some amount of hydrogen gas. Can you expect how many hydrogen molecules are there? You cannot expect, because I am saying some amount of hydrogen gas. I didn't mention whether it is 1 mole of hydrogen gas, or it is 1 gram of hydrogen gas, or it is 1 liter of hydrogen gas. I didn't mention the amount of hydrogen gas. Just I am saying some amount of hydrogen gas is taken. So when some amount of hydrogen gas is taken in the evacuated electric discharge tube, and that hydrogen gas containing so many molecules, then that hydrogen gas is subjected to electric discharge by using high voltages. Here the voltage must be more than 13.6 electron volts. Then only the hydrogen gas is undergoing electric discharge in the electric discharge tube. The gas is going to contain molecules. Hydrogen gas is going to contain the molecules. This is a 1 molecule of hydrogen gas. This is 1 molecule of hydrogen gas represented as hydrogen, single bond hydrogen. When this hydrogen gas is undergoing electric discharge, what will happen means the bond between the atoms is going to get dissociated, bond breaking or bond fission. That is the dissociation. So dissociation of hydrogen gas molecules is going to happen when the gas is subjected to electric discharge by using more than 13.6 electron volts of energy. Then we are going to have hydrogen atoms in the electric discharge tube. So by using electricity of more than 13.6 electron volts, when the hydrogen gas is subjected to electric discharge, we are going to get hydrogen atoms in the electric discharge tube. We are continuously passing the electricity. Electricity is also a form of energy. So whenever we are having the hydrogen atoms in the electric discharge tube, still we are passing the electricity, that is electric discharge, then these hydrogen atoms that dissociated, due to the dissociation, the obtained hydrogen atoms, they are going to gain additional energy. When the atoms are going to gain additional energy, the atoms get excited. What is meant by excitation? Excitation means moving the electrons in the atoms, moving the electrons in the atoms from lower energy levels to higher energy levels. Once again, moving the electrons from lower energy levels to higher energy levels by absorption of energy. That process is called as excitation process. So when the hydrogen gas is subjected to electric discharge, first we are going to get the hydrogen atoms. Those hydrogen atoms, they are going to get excited. Now we are having the excited hydrogen atoms in the electric discharge tube. All of you know, the excited hydrogen atoms contain absorbed energy. Once again, the excited hydrogen atoms are going to contain absorbed energy. Always, the excited atoms or the excited molecules, they are unstable. They are going to emit energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation. The excited atoms, they are going to emit energy. Now, we will get it out. Sir, we took some hydrogen gas. We don't know how many hydrogen molecules are there. And we don't know how many hydrogen atoms are obtained. And we don't know how many hydrogen atoms are get excited. That means some hydrogen molecules are going to get dissociate to form the hydrogen atoms. And that hydrogen atoms are going to get excited. Right, now the point is, this is suppose the ground state. This is the first excited state. This is the second excited state. This is the third excited state. This is the fourth excited state. Like that, so many excited states are there. And different excited hydrogen atoms, they are going to move to different excited levels. Actually, the atoms are not going to get excited. The electrons in the atoms are going to get excited. And the excited electrons, they may be in the first excited state or in the second excited state or in the third excited state, like that. In the excited state, the excited electrons are unstable. They are going to emit energy, emission of energy. When the emitted energy is going to collected on a photographic film, we will get a spectrum. That spectrum is called as line emission spectrum. The spectrum is called as line emission spectrum. Simply, I am saying here, it is the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. So to form the line spectrum of hydrogen atom, what is the conditions required? In the electric discharge tube, the electricity must be taken more than 13.6 electron volts, and the electric discharge tube must be evacuated. Right, this is the main condition. Now, we are going to see the hydrogen spectrum, line spectrum of hydrogen atom. On the screen, I'm going to show you the formation of line spectrum of hydrogen atom. On the screen, you can see now. Yes, once observe that spectrum given on the left side. The spectrum is given on the left side. My dear students, by using your two fingers on the screen, by touching on the screen, mobile screen, you can enlarge the diagram. You can enlarge the diagram. You can observe the diagram very clearly. Yes, once observe the diagram, I will explain later. For 1 or 2 minutes, just diagram. Just give me a minute. I have to check the board. Yes, the board is clear. Once again, I'm sharing the screen. Okay. Yes, if you observe the a group of spectral lines formed, where the group of spectral lines you can observe, n is equal to 1 is given. See here, n is equal to 1 is given. This is the ground state. Here, n is equal to 2 is given. That is the first excited state. Next, n is equal to 3. Second excited state. N is equal to 4. Third excited state. Like that, all these are the different excited states which are present in the hydrogen atom. And N is equal to 1 indicates this is the ground state of hydrogen atom. As in the ground state, you can observe some group of lines. In the first excited state, N is equal to 2, you can see some group of lines. But in N is equal to 2, you can observe different colored lines were given. Right, coming to the next, second excited state. Second excited state means N is equal to 3. Here you can see some more group of spectral lines. So in the every excited state, we can see the formation of some group of spectral lines. Group of collective spectral lines is called as a spectrum. Right, coming to the board. So first I am taking N is equal to 1. N is equal to 1. Here it is N. N is equal to 1. N is equal to 1 means it is the first orbit. N is equal to 1 indicating it is the first orbit of hydrogen atom. N is equal to 2 means second orbit of hydrogen atom. N is equal to 3 is the third orbit of hydrogen atom. Fourth orbit of hydrogen atom. Fifth orbit of hydrogen atom. Sixth orbit of hydrogen atom. And seventh orbit of hydrogen atom, like that. But N is equal to 1 is indicating it is the ground state of hydrogen atom. And when the hydrogen gas is subjected to electric discharge, first of all, hydrogen atoms are formed and they are going to get excited. We don't know whether the hydrogen atoms are excited to first excited state or the hydrogen atoms are excited to second excited state. We don't know. Suppose if the electrons in the hydrogen atoms are excited to seventh excited state. See this one? This is the seventh excited state. From this seventh excited state, if the excited electron is going to lose, or the excited electron is going to emit absorbed radiation, then we can see the formation of a spectral line. From N is equal to 7 to N is equal to 1 due to emission of absorbed radiation. And suppose the electrons are excited to 6th excited state, and the excited electron from 6th excited state by emitting energy, if the electron is directly coming back to ground state. Again, we can see the formation of a spectral line like that. If the excited electron of hydrogen atom is present in the fifth orbit, then the excited electron is going to emit absorbed radiation, and the excited electron from fifth orbit is directly coming to ground state. Ground state means, what is meant by ground state? N is equal to 1. So here we can see formation of spectral lines. Like that, we can also take N is equal to 4. Here, excited electron is present, and the excited electron is going to emit the absorbed radiation. And due to emission of energy, if the electron is coming back to ground state, again we can see the formation of a spectral line. Like that. Now from N is equal to 3 to N is equal to 1, if the electron is going to emit energy, emission of energy by the excited electrons. Once again, the emission of energy by the excited electrons That process is called as de-excitation. The process is known as de-excitation. So during the de-excitation process, what is going to happen? During the de-excitation process, what is happened? Emission of absorbed radiation is going to happen. Emission of absorbed radiation is going to happen during the de-excitation process. As a result, electrons in the excited atoms are coming from higher energy to the electrons are coming from higher energy level to higher energy level to lower energy level. During the de-excitation process, due to emission of absorbed radiation by the excited electrons in the atoms, the electrons are coming from higher energy levels to lower energy levels. So here you are seeing electrons in the sixth excited state, means seventh orbit, they are coming to ground state. Electron in the sixth orbit means fifth excited state, coming to ground state. Like that, here one more de-excitation. What is one more de-excitation possible here? Text me. What is one more de-excitation possible here? To the ground state. To the ground state, one more de-excitation is possible from where to where? From which orbit to which orbit? From which orbit to which orbit? Here, one more de-excitation is possible. Right, very good. So one more de-excitation is possible, that is from second orbit to, here second orbit is called as first excited state. So from the second orbit to first orbit, what is happening? From second orbit to first orbit, what is happening? From second orbit to first orbit, what is happening? Very good. De-excitation of Yoga Venkata Prasad. What is de-excitation of what? Right, de-excitation of excited electrons. Once again, de-excitation of excited electrons is happening. So finally, if any further de-excitation is possible to the ground state, is any further de-excitation is possible? Yes, correct. No de-excitation is further possible. So in the ground state, this is the ground state. This is the ground state. So to the ground state, the de-excitation is possible from, to the ground state, the de-excitation is possible from any higher energy level to any higher energy level to ground state, from any higher energy level to ground state, if the de-excitation is happening, they are going to give a group of spectral lines. This group of spectral lines is named as Lyman, L-Y-M-A-N-N, Lyman series. This group of spectral lines is named as Lyman series. And that Lyman series, we can't see this Lyman series. Yes, wait a minute, I'm going to share the screen again. Once check the screen. So on the screen on the left side, you can see the diagram. On the right side of the diagram, you can see N is equal to 1 is given. N is equal to 1 indicating that is the ground state. And all these are the lines. These lines are indicating, what those lines are indicating? De-excitation of excited electrons from any higher energy level to ground state. So during the de-excitation of electrons from any higher energy level to ground state is going to happen, what will be the series is going to be formed, means Lyman series. Yes, on the screen you can see on the right side, some box is given, some table is given. Once observe the table. So the first series formed is Lyman series. Here N1 is always equal to 1. Whereas N2 may be second orbit, or N2 may be third orbit, or N2 may be fourth orbit. Here N2 means any higher energy state. Once again, N2 means any higher energy state. So when N1 is equal to 1, N2 is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on, what is the series going to be formed? Lyman series. And we can't see that Lyman series, because the Lyman series is going to be formed in the ultraviolet region. We know the electromagnetic spectrum, gamma rays, UV rays, gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, infrared rays, microwaves, radio waves. So there are different types of electromagnetic radiations are there, but we are able to see only visible spectrum. So UV rays, we can't see the UV rays. So we can't observe by the naked eye. What we can't observe is Lyman series. So this is the first series going to be formed in the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. So in the line spectrum of hydrogen atom, in the ground state, what is happening? De-excitation of excited electrons from any excited state to ground state is going to happen to give the spectrum. That group of spectrum or the group of spectral lines formed is called as Lyman series, and that will not be observed by the naked eye because it is formed in the ultraviolet region. Based on these, you are having the MCQs. If you bought the material, then you can go through the material, you can observe. Some MCQs are given based on this concept, particularly based on this table. You can easily understand the topic, you can solve the questions. Right, coming to the second one, suppose the excited electrons from any excited state, if the excited electrons are going to come back to the second level, then a group of spectral lines will be formed and they are visible. Visible means they are going to be formed in the visible region. And these were observed by the scientist Balmer. Here, L is the silent, Balmer. So Balmer series. So in the Balmer series, where the Balmer series is going to be formed? N is equal to 2. Or simply we can say N1 is equal to 2. See the table here on the right side. Balmer series is going to be formed when ground state. Here ground state is considered as N1. Excited states are considered as N2. Once again, the ground state is considered as N1. Excited states are considered as N2. So for the Balmer series, ground state is equal to 2. Once again, for the Balmer series, ground state is equal to 2. Excited states are 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. And the Balmer series is going to be formed in visible region. Yes, coming to the board. Yes, now tell me. So this is about formation of Lyman series in the N is equal to 1 or N1 is equal to 1, and the Lyman series is formed in UV region. Right. Now tell me, what is the next series? That is the visible region, and the series is called as Balmer series. Now the excitation possibilities. From any higher energy level to second level. Once again, from any higher energy level to second level, what is happening here? Emission of energy by the excited electrons. What is happening here? Emission of absorbed energy by the excited electrons is happening. Emission of absorbed energy by the excited electrons is happening. And the excited electrons from any higher energy level coming to the second level. See here, N is equal to 2. Like that, we can write the remaining de-excitations. This is one de-excitation. Tell me the next de-excitation. From where to where? Next day excitation, right? Sixth level to second level. sixth level to second level de-excitation, fifth level to second level de-excitation, fourth level to second level de-excitation, third level to second level de-excitation. Here again we can see a group of spectral lines. They are visible, and these were observed by the scientist Balmer. So it is the Balmer series, and this series is formed in visible region. Visible region. Yes, once again I am sharing the screen. Once check the visible region on the screen, you can see the spectrum. Once check the visible region. Yes, tell me, what is the first line? What is the first line in the visible region? Whether it is the first red line or green line or blue line or violet line. What is the first line of visible region? Based on this, again, MCQs are there. What is the first line of visible region? My dear student, what is the ground state of visible region? What is the ground state? Wait. Don't text, please. What is the ground state of visible region? What is the ground state of visible region? N is equal to 2. N is equal to 2 is the ground state of visible region. What is the first excited state of visible region? What is the first excited state of visible region? N is equal to 3. Yes. So N is equal to 3 to N is equal to 2. N is equal to 3 to N is equal to 2. Whether it is the first line or second line or third line. So here we have to use the words H alpha, H beta, H gamma, H delta. But in the NCERT textbook, it is not given. Right? So based on this, we will discuss later. Wait. Next, say the next one. Next series. N is equal to 3. N is equal to 3. N is equal to 3 is indicating, again, it is the ground state for Passion series. See the spelling. P-A-S-C-H-E-N. Passion. Pronunciation, sometimes it may be different. Passion series. And the Passion series again formed in the infrared region. So, coming to the board. Infrared region. So, first series formed is Lyman series in the UV region. Second series formed is Balmer series in the visible region. The third series formed is from the seventh level to third level, de-excitation is happening. From the sixth level to third level, de-excitation is happening. From the fifth level to third level, de-excitation is happening. From the fourth level to third level, de-excitation is happening. So when the de-excitation is happening from any higher energy level to third level, first level, second level, third level. Once again, the de-excitation is happening from any higher energy level to third level, then again a group of spectral lines are obtained. These are called as Passion series or Passion pronunciation. P-A-S-C-H-E-N. Passion or Passion. Simply we can say Passion series or Passion series. And according to electromagnetic spectrum, UV region, next visible region, next after UV visible, what is the next region? Infrared region simply represented as IR region. So in our NCERT textbook, only about three regions are given. That is Lyman series in the UV region, Balmer series in the visible region, and the Passion series in the infrared region. Of course, two more series are also given in other textbooks. That is from seventh level to what is the level? 1, 2, 3, 4. From the seventh level to fourth level, de-excitation is happening. From the sixth level to fourth level, de-excitation is happening. From the fifth level to fourth level, de-excitation is happening. So again, we can see a group of spectral lines. This is called as bracket series. Of course, it is also formed in the infrared region. Of course, this is also formed in the infrared region. And lastly, Again, de-excitation from 7th level to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7th level to 5th level de-excitation. 6th level to 5th level de-excitation. Again, a group of speckle lines. This is called as PFUND. We can say P fund series, or simply we can say fund series. Fund series. So it is the P fund series or fund series. Again, this is formed in the infrared region. But the first one, passion series, is formed in the near of the infrared region. Near to the infrared region. Bracket series is going to be formed in the middle of the infrared region. And P fund series or the fund series is formed away from the infrared region. Away, that is far away from the infrared region. So this is the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. Yes, again you will get it out. Sir, between first level to second level, the gap is maximum. Between second level to third level, the gap is decreased. Third level to fourth level, the gap is decreased. Fourth level to fifth level, the gap is decreased. Fifth level to sixth level, again the gap is decreased. From sixth level to seventh level, the gap is decreased. You will get it out by seeing this diagram. But most of the students are writing the gaps with equal gaps. That is not correct diagram. We must maintain the maximum gap between first energy level to second energy level. Then the energy level gaps are going to slowly get a decrease. This is going to be explained by Niels Bohr by calculating the energies of the orbits of atoms. Energies of the orbits of atoms. The energies of the orbits of atoms is given by En. Here N stands for number of orbit. If we take first orbit, we can say energy of the first orbit, energy of the second orbit, energy of the third orbit. The energies of the orbits that was given by Niels Bohr. In the next classes, we will discuss why these gaps are going to be like this. Just now, just remember. So this is all about the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. But in the textbook, once again, I'm sharing the textbook. Wait a minute. Yes, once again, see on the screen. So in the textbook, only three regions are given. One is Lyman series in the ultraviolet region. Second one is Balmer series in the visible region. Next one, Passion series are given in the infrared region. Of course, if you see at the top, N is equal to infinity. Infinity means you can take any number of excited states. But in general, we are taking only five series. The first series, see the table here once again. See the table. Lyman series, Balmer series, Passion series, Bracket series, Fund series. Here, Passion series also called as Passion, C-H-E-N, Passion series. So for these series, the ground states are N is equal to 1 for Lyman series, N1 is equal to 2 for Balmer series, N1 is equal to 3 for Passion series, N1 is equal to 4 for Bracket series, N1 is equal to 5 for Fund series. So these values, N1 values indicates ground states of these series. N2 values are indicating excited states of these series. Right? In the next class, we will discuss why these energy gaps are like this. To discuss that one, we have to know about Niels Bohr's model of atom. So mostly in the next class, I will start the class. Just a minute, I have to take the attendance. Yes, one more point I have to explain, but tomorrow I will explain. Every line, if you see every line in the spectrum, if you see every line in the spectrum, that is indicating emission of energy. Emission of energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations. The electromagnetic radiations are going to possess frequency, wavelength, and wave number. Once again, the electromagnetic radiations are going to possess frequency, wavelength, and wave number. Wave number is indicated by nu bar. On the screen, you can see the formula is given. Nu bar is equal to, nu bar means, what is meant by nu bar? Wave number of electromagnetic radiation. So nu bar is equal to 1,09,677 into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square centimeter inverse. The formula is given as nu bar is equal to 1,09,677 into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square centimeter inverse. This was explained by Rydberg.